thank you for coming. The remarkable story of David's great gift for music, the support and encouragement given to him, not only by his family, but by generous, thoughtful patrons, Emily Sibley Watson and George Eastman, and David's selfless decision to join the war effort, leading to his death far too young, is one that continues to inspire us today. At this 100th anniversary of David Hochstein's death in battle in the Argonne Forest, it is fitting that we remember how his passing was mourned, not only by his family and friends, but by our entire community. In February of 1919, the members of the Rochester Symphony Orchestra adopted a resolution beginning with these words: "He is dead, the sweet musician. He has moved a little nearer to the master of all music." The resolution continues: "With these beautiful words of a noble poet, we wish to express our heartfelt love and sympathy to the bereaved family of our beloved friend and musician, David Hochstein. Endowed with the God-given grace of musical genius, his name stands nobly recorded as one of the best known and beloved of the musicians of America today, whose fame will abide in the old world as well as the new. At the call of his country, he joined with ranks of millions of other young Americans and there showed the same ability for achievement and leadership by winning his commission as lieutenant after reaching the shores of France. And in this manner, he was called to meet his death bravely while inspiring those under him to bravery, and the grand diapason of battle was the music chosen by fate for the close of his young life, rather than the more gentle harmonies of the art he loved and so ably interpreted." 2 months after that, Rochester musicians gave a concert in his memory. It was attended by thousands. And funds raised at that concert led to the creation of a music school named in his memory, fulfilling his cherished hope of enriching the lives of children in the very neighborhood where he grew up. Today, that school, known now simply as the Hochstein School, carries on his legacy. We are so immensely grateful for this legacy, not only of musicianship and artistry, but also of character, commitment, and courage. David Hochstein's life was and is an inspiration. It has inspired our work at the Hochstein School, and I'm certain it will continue to do so for far longer than any of us can imagine. Very pleased to note today that we are joined by several local and state officials and representatives. New York State Senator Joseph Robach. Is Sandra Simon here? Sandra Simon, Director of Special Projects and Education Initiatives for the City of Rochester. Elizabeth Morabito, representing Harry Bronson, New York State Assemblyman. And Monroe County Legislator John Lightfoot. Thank you for being here today. Senator Robach and Ms. Simon have agreed to share a few words. Senator Robach?
Good morning. Thank you. I'm delighted to be here along with all of you. This is a nice remembrance, 100 years, and it's really true. I can come at this three ways, both as a Rochesterian, a sloppy drummer, and also someone who has the privilege of representing our community in the state legislature. There's no question, David Hochstein certainly was a very unique and great individual that came from our community. Not only was he musically very talented, spoke six languages, he had so much going on in his life and a lot to sacrifice, yet he was very anxious to serve in the military and was willing to stand up, even with his own life, to fight that tyranny and aggression that was going on in the world at that time. So he was a unique individual, and that unfortunately, the catalyst for this great school was his passing. The idea that people could get music, dance, instruments, and learn those for free from throughout the community was rare indeed. And so to all the people that keep that legacy alive every day, the volunteers, the people that contribute, it's great. So I'll say, as someone who likes music, I like that. But as someone who's in the state legislature, I like it even more, because we know kids that do music do better in math and science, have a greater graduation rate. We're spending a lot of your resources to make sure we get everybody to that. And I'm just a believer, even though it's somewhat anecdotal, I think music is a common denominator and a bond that makes the world a little bit nicer and kinder, and that David Hochstein could do all that along with the people that kept his great legacy alive is remarkable. So it's great that we're here to remember his 100th year anniversary, and hopefully we can all share this great Rochesterian and share that story with somebody I know, and how fortunate we were to have him, albeit for a short time, amongst our midst and have such a great legacy living on. Thank you.
I ditto what he said. That's why I love having him go before I go. But nevertheless, I'm here representing Mayor Lovely A. Warren, and I'm sorry that she's unable to be with you this morning, but I personally have seen the legacy of what the Hochstein family has done, and I am so very proud that the legacy is strong in Rochester, New York, and the fact that they have gone on beyond Rochester. They, all of the young men, musicians, women, children that you have taught have gone to other schools, other areas, I have traveled, not a lot, but some of the places I have, I've heard them say, I went to Hochstein. I played the violin because I went to Hochstein, or I played the oboe because I went to Hochstein, or I play the saxophone. I love the saxophone because of Hochstein. So I think that our legacy, we need to be proud of what the Hochsteins have left us, particularly in the fact that it is not just centered in Rochester, but it's all over the United States and probably beyond. But I'd like to read something from Mayor Warren. She has a certificate, and you can hold that for me, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
Anything for you, Sandy.
That's what they all say. Thank you. I'm honored to join you today on behalf of Mayor Lovely Warren, who sends her regrets. David Hochstein was born to an immigrant family on Joseph Avenue. He was there that he discovered his talent and passion. His future was bright, with fame and fortune within his grasp, but he instead sacrificed everything to enlist and serve in World War I. He gave up his dream, so his children living Joseph Avenue today can reach for the stars and aspire to new heights. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, I always say that could be correctly, once said, "The life of a man consists not in seeing visions and in dreaming dreams, but in active charity and in willing services." This is why we honor him, and that is why the school which bears his name serves children of all ages and all walks of life. So I'd like to present this to you.
Thank you so much.
In honor of this talented Rochester native, whose musical genius, along with the generosity of local benefactors, enabled him to become a renowned violinist, performing on some of the world's greatest stages. Although his patriotism and love of country would result in his loss of life during World War I at the age of 26 years of age, Hochstein's death galvanized our community to build and operate music school in his honor. Now, 100 years after his passing, the Hochstein School continues to preserve his legacy by welcoming all those interested in the arts and by providing music, dance, and artistic opportunities to all individuals, regardless of age, ability, or economic status. Mayor Lovely A. Warren, congratulations.
Thanks.